Okay, 7:47 precisely. I'm very precise. And now it's time to welcome our guest into the studio. But before we do that, should we turn the cameras on? So you can see her as well as hear her. Yeah.
Five,
you can almost
four,
taste her.
3, 2, 1.
Cameras are on. There's me. Hello. Come and watch us online, bbc.co.uk/radio1. And there, looking beautiful. Looking so nice, all dreamy, is Kesha. Morning, Kesha.
Good morning.
How you doing?
I'm good.
Yes?
I can't believe you do this every day.
Well, it's tough, isn't it?
It's so early.
But you know, okay now?
Kind of.
You know? At first, when you first wake up, you're like, what am I doing?
I can't believe I used to get up this early for school.
I know, terrifying, but you're here, so thank you, Kesha.
Radio 1 Breakfast Show with Nick Grimshaw.
Do you know, the first few days, the first day I got up when I started, I was super excited, because dream job, so I just jumped out of bed, I was like, yeah. Second day in, I was like, this is getting tough, day two. The other morning, though, what I did was got up too early. My phone went, I thought it was my alarm. It was someone calling me, but it just triggered me. So I just woke up, got in the shower, got dressed, went in the lounge, and then it was 3:55 a.m.
Oh, that's the worst. Well, I just kind of kept myself up most of the night in preparation for this.
Okay, good. Lots of preparation for this interview. So it's going to be good.
Yeah,
it's going to be real.
Oh,
absolutely. It's going to be the one. I'm really sorry for terrifying you in the corridor just then.
Yeah, I thought you were going to kill me.
No, I'd never kill Kesha.
I mean, you had this look on your face.
I did not have any look on my face.
Looking vicious.
I just went for a quick week. Because when you were in the live lounge there, here at Radio 1, the live lounge is next door to the studio, so you can see through. But obviously, it's soundproof because it's a radio. So I could see you and we were talking, but kind of mime talking to one another.
Right.
And you did, if you are watching online, I'll demonstrate this. You did this sort of charade to me, which was a squat leg with two arms going from the chest down in between the legs.
Like a waterfall.
Yes, like a waterfall. And I didn't know what that meant, because I was talking about exfoliation. So I was like, I don't know where this is going here, Kesha. But that sign was, I need to wee.
Yes, and you got that. I was really proud.
Yes, I'm really good at that.
We'd be good charades partner.
We should definitely do it tonight after the show. We should definitely do it. So I also had to do the old waterfall. And on the way to the bathroom, ran into Kesha and terrified you. So sorry.
No, it's all right.
I feel like that's a good energy start to the day, though.
Yeah, I did scream.
You really did scream. Also made so much worse because it was just me and you. There was no one else around there.
Super awkward.
Super awkward. Yeah. Well, sorry. And then welcome to the show.
Thanks.
I saw you complaining on Twitter.
I was not complaining. I was kind of complaining.
Yeah, kind of.
But I was painting my nails in the car, so it's all right.
Yeah, you're okay. Is this horrendous, having to be up this early, Kesha?
No, it is. It is terrible. It's but I did just kind of stay awake all night. Like, I kept, like, just myself up. Because I figured if I have to be funny or amusing somehow, I should just stay awake.
Just stay awake. So what did you do last night?
I painted my nails, like, 5 times. And
let's see.
They're really ugly.
They're not that good. Is one missing?
Yeah, one's missing. They're really ugly. And I ate some candy. I watched some movies.
Uh-huh. What did you watch?
I drank some wine. Something about a serial killer, which is why I screamed when I saw you, because I'm really kind of like, I scared myself.
About a DJ serial.
Yeah.
He kills you with a 12-inch record. 12-inch record. And then you came here today, and then how long are you in London for? Do you get time to hang out, or is it just all work when you're
here? Yeah, I actually get to be here for a couple of days, which is fun, because I always have a really good time here. I have a bunch of friends that are trannies, and they always take me out and show me the best time here.
Oh, amazing.
Yeah.
You can always have fun with those guys.
Yeah.
Where are you going to go?
I don't know. I never know. They just take me. They pick me up, and they throw me in a van, and then we just go. And
they're
they bring
gonna...
me back, like, a couple days later.
And your label are like, yay. I love it when the trannies kidnap Kesha. They're not going to like the nail job, though.
No, they will be mortified at this nail job. I need to get them fixed, actually, before I see my tranny friend.
You really need to get them fixed. I saw you wanted to go to a haunted house as well.
Mm. I'm very much in, like, the Halloween spirit, and I love scaring myself and being scared by DJs. 7 in the morning. No, I love being scared. So, yeah, I do want to go to a haunted house.
I can take you to one if you want.
Do they have one here?
I know you've got a busy day with the trannies, but if you can fit in half an hour, I can take you to one, which was genuinely terrifying.
You can take the trannies too.
Yeah, okay, let's all go.
That'd be fun.
Yeah, Finchie?
No.
It's genuinely terrifying. I took my niece when she was probably about 15 or something, so a couple of years ago, and we went. It's on the Thames, and we go and you walk through it, but it's kind of like it's just a hospital. Oh, it's the hospital tour. So you're like, okay, everything's normal, and then all of a sudden, like, the nurse dies, and then the hospital patients are zombies and they chase you. Terrifying.
That's so fun. I love being chased with, like, chainsaws.
But yeah, it was. I hated it. Okay, it was awful. And my niece, I think, was traumatized. She's still in therapy. Sorry, Liv. Yeah. So we're going to play your new record now, Kesha.
Okay, I love that.
This is exciting.
That will wake everybody up.
This will wake everybody up.
Good.
Is it nice to be back and doing things and doing pop star things? Because you've had time away from the limelight. Which is always weird, I think, someone saying to you, you've had time off. Because you've probably been like, no, I've not.
I haven't had time off. I've been locked in the studio and making music with some of my idols. So it hasn't been time off, but it has been really fun. Like, I've gotten to work with the most amazing people on this record. Like, people I've listened to since I was little, and like Iggy Pop, who's a
no way.
He's a god. Like, he's a god to me.
How's he working with Iggy Pop?
It was maybe the best experience of my life. He's so amazing and he's so nice, and he's like the epitome of punk rock same time, and he's such a nice person. He's so smart. I don't know, I could go on forever.
But did he wear a shirt to studio ever?
No, he didn't. And he, I was so happy that he was topless. Like, brought me to tears. I was so happy.
Maybe that's how I need to be as successful as Iggy Pop.
Take your shirt off.
Yeah,
start now.
Yeah, do you think?
Try it.
No, I can't.
Come on.
I can't. I don't have Iggy's belly.
Don't be shy.
I'm very shy, Kesha. So you work with Iggy Pop, which is insane to go and work with him. How do you even get in touch with Iggy Pop? Because I imagine you can't tweet him.
No, I actually have been harassing him for years now. I love to stalk people. It's like one of my hobbies.
I've been harassing Iggy Pop for years, actually.
No, I have been. I try to just weasel my way in there, and sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. But this time, fortunately, it worked.
It was a good harassment.
Yeah, it was good. I just don't stop bothering people until they finally have to acknowledge my presence. Uh-huh. And I actually did the same thing with the Flaming Lips. That's how I got a lot of people on my record, actually, is I just bothered the hell out of them.
So how is it working with them? Because, again, that's incredible people to work with, Flaming Lips.
Flaming Lips. Well, now so cool. Wayne and I are really good friends. Like, he texts me all the time, and he's a weirdo.
He is a weirdo, isn't he?
But we're like musical soulmates. I don't know. He showed up at my house, and I gave him his first tattoo on his toe. And he was, like, finger-banging my bowl of glitter. Because in my house, I have this huge bowl of glitter, obviously.
Obviously, I'm Kesha, duh.
Yeah, and so he was, like, finger-banging it. Can I say that on the air?
I don't even know what it means. I think that's an American thing. Absolutely no idea what that means. I'm just like,
okay, it's probably better that way. But he showed up at my house and stayed. He wouldn't leave for, like, days.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, you're a nice host.
Kinda.
Yeah. Only if you're in the Flaming Lips, though.
Yeah, well, I just can't cook anything, and I'm relatively useless in those ways, but I have the world's biggest bed.
Yep, that's good.
So,
how big are we talking? Like, well, half the size of this room?
Oh, the size of this room.
No way.
Yeah. No, my most diva moment is when I was like, I want the world's biggest bed. And so I got the dimensions of the biggest bed, and then I made mine bigger.
No way.
Yeah, way.
So bigger than this room?
It's really big.
That's
but
thick.
I fit the whole Flaming Lips and some of my friends and my cousin and my cat comfortably.
Night, everybody. Night the Flaming Lips. Night Iggy Pop. I did when I went to go and get a bed, because I don't really know how to do things as an adult. You know, when you go and do things for the first time, like buy an oven or buy a bed, like, I don't know what to check
I don't know
for.
How to do that either.
Well, you don't until you've done it. Or, like, do the garden. You're like, I don't know how a plant lives. Like, what? So when I went to go and get the bed that I've got now, I said, I want a really good bed. And he was like, well, do you want a good bed in terms of size or mattress springing or the amount of something in it? I was like, I don't know, just, like, the best one. He said, well, you're going to have to talk to me about what you consider to be the best bed. I was like, what bed would Beyonce have? And he was like, that one. So now the bed is called Beyonce.
Really? Mm-hmm. My bed's bigger, I bet.
Yeah, yours is bigger than Beyonce. No. I'm going to have to downgrade mine from, like, Beyoncé to... And then, like, one other Saturdays or something. Right, let's play your new record. This is Kesha's brand new song. This is Die Young
on
BBC Radio 1.
Radio 1 News Space, it's 4 minutes past eight.
Thank you, Tina DeHealy.
Thank you, Nick.
Oh, look what Tina's wearing. You look like you've dressed up for Kesha.
I'm wearing a
You're
sparkly
glittery.
Jumper. I know. It's sparkly. Do you like it?
I love anything that sparkles.
Thanks.
I like it, Tina. Give us a move, like, give us a shoulder shake.
Enough of that.
Thank you, Tina.
Bye.
Bye. Right, Kesha is here. We're going to play some records and we're going to have a proper chat.
All right.
Okay, I'm going to be serious.
Oh,
we're not even going to play music. It's just serious questions.
Serious?
For 1 hour.
That's so boring.
No, not really.
Okay.
What we want you to do as well, we're going to do something that we do for a few people, but only if they're like super famous. We're going to do it for something for all of your super fans out there, your animals.
I love my animals.
We did it with Ed Sheeran on Tuesday. We did it with Conor Maynard. Now it is time, though, to ask for fans of Kesha to come forward. If you're on Twitter, I imagine everyone's on Twitter, right?
Most people.
I think so. Literally apart from my mum. We're going to do Follow a Fan today with Kesha. You need to tweet us at R1Breakfast with the hashtag Follow a Fan. And at some point today, Kesha's going to follow you. I think we're going to take our time and do it after the show, aren't we?
Yeah.
Find the right one.
I'm excited.
We're going to do months of research.
I'm so excited.
Make sure you're not a lunatic. But if you want Kesha to follow you and send you a little message.
I like the lunatics. I don't care if you are a lunatic.
If you are a lunatic, get in touch at R1Breakfast. I love management representations like, no, people from the level are like, no more lunatics. All the terms and conditions are online. We'll post them on Twitter now. Take a read and get tweeting for your ultimate bragging reward that Kesha is like totally cool with you and you're like fine and everything. But get in touch now at R1Breakfast with the hashtag Follow a Fan and we'll do it after this.
This is the UK's official...